What's up, everyone, and thanks for dropping in to the Matrix Movie Reviews with your boy Prime. And I'm going to break down the movie Batman the Killing Joke. This movie was established from the epic novel Batman Killing Joke that was established back in 1988. That was one of the best comics that's in the Batman series. But from the movie standpoint, there was a lot of key moments, and there were some moments that were really, you know, questionable. So I'm going to start out with the obvious, and we're going to start with first. I would say the animation for this particular type of movie did not fit. I did not care of the particular animation that they went with. This was something that was particular because it didn't just bring out the movie. It made it more such as a cartoon, not such as animation. People get stuff mixed up as it being a cartoon to the pose of animation. Animation has a little bit more sharper, visuals to make it a little bit more serious. They could have went with some individuals that did previous Batman animations. I don't know if anybody had watched Batman Gotham before, but they had a couple sequences from a couple of companies that did some of the animations, and they could have used some of them. But you know, I guess the WB went with their classic like the anime series, and they went with that particular drawings and that such, but it didn't give it a serious tone with the visual. So you really can't take the movie seriously with that particular type of animation. You'll see it as much as a cartoon to the pose of the animation. Acting. The acting was very, very good. I would say that. And again, this movie was directed by Sam Liu. And now I would say the beginning of the movie was kind of good to an extent. The villain that was actually in the movie, his name was Francisco. Now, it was played by John DiMaggio. He did a very, very good job as playing the villain of him. And the interaction between, now Batgirl is in this as well with Barbara Gordon. And Barbara Gordon is played by Tara Strong. And what I can say about the interaction with that is that, well, let me break this down. Batman and Batgirl is actually teamed up. And what's kind of confusing is that y'all got to remember that when Batgirl actually joined the Batman family, well, it wasn't called the Batman family then, but when she was actually introduced, Dick Grayson was actually Robin at the time. So, you know, and they gave Batgirl Barbara Gordon, actually a particular scene where she interacted with Bruce after an altercation. If y'all go ahead and watch it, y'all actually see that was something that was really, really questionable, because I can tell you that Barbara Gordon and Dick Grayson, he was actually the one that had a crush on Barbara Gordon at the time when she was first introduced. And that's something in history that you would need to know. But in this installment, they actually made Bruce and Barbara have a little bit something going there, and they were actually partners in this sequence. Now, that was just mainly the first half of the movie, and then he was trying to give her advice on this particular villain, which was Francisco, and how some of his psychological things was actually in place, and he was trying to help her in this aspect. And knowing how young and, you know, individuals are, they should be a little bit naive and, you know, trying to be bullheaded, and certain things actually transpire and goes on. But I would like and I did like that interaction of the actual how Batman was trying to tell Batgirl, you know, certain things. Well, who was Barbara? Certain things. And this is at the beginning. Now, this is something that was actually added to this movie to make it, you know, interesting. But I can say that, you know, Francisco, he did a good job. He was a very interesting villain, a very questionable character. He was kind of psychological, conniving, psychotic. But at the same time, he was actually doing that to Batgirl. Bruce already knew that, you know, the situation. He already broke the character down. The villain down. He already knew, because you know how he is. But in that aspect, then once we got to the middle of the movie, then we already knew everything about the Killing Joke. If you had read the graphic novel, everything was carried out exactly the way the book was, unlike to a T. The only things I would say that was in the movie that I would actually say that bothered me was some parts of the action sequences or some of the acting, it didn't like make you feel these certain parts, like the emotional part in one scene. It wasn't real emotional. It didn't make you feel it. Well, everybody knows that Barbara Gordon, she gets shot by the Joker. Everybody knows that. But that part was not like it was significant enough like it was in the comic, in the graphic novel, where, you know, you can feel it. You can actually see her, how surprised she was. In this, it really didn't show all that. Now, the key individuals was that, you know, you have Kevin Conroy, who played Bruce Wayne in Batman, and you had Mark Hamill, you know, who plays Joker. You know, so, I mean, those are the two standout individuals that stand out in the movie. And, you know, Wade Wise, he plays Commissioner Gordon as well. But those are the two standout, you know, characters that was actually in the movie. So you already know those two. Everybody knows that Kevin Conroy is actually the Bat, you know, and, you know, he does Batman extremely well. Just, and Mark Hamill does Joker extremely well. But all I could say, people, is that I would give this an actual 6.5. Yeah, 6.5. And the reason why I do that, because I'm a, like I say, it was good, but then there was like certain elements that kind of, that was kind of, it didn't bother me. It was just certain things that just didn't add up in the way that they did it. And then they made like Barbara Gordon be this particular individual that she wasn't. And then we also know what the end, what actually happens at that sequence. So if you actually watch it, you will understand. But all I could tell you is that I would say about maybe 15, maybe about 15, 20 minutes in, after you get into it, the rest of the movie is strictly from the graphic novel. Everything is. But some of the acting sequences, certain of the real moments where it's supposed to be extreme acting, it wasn't there for me. Okay, it just wasn't there. It wasn't that emotion, that, you know, that real power, that oomph. It was not there for me. And I wish they would have translated that a little bit better. There was a gentleman, and one of the sequences that Joker did, Mark Hamill, don't get me wrong, Mark Hamill did a good job, but there was one scene that really didn't get me, was the song scene. If everybody knows, that's in the book, that he did a song scene where he had Commissioner Gordon and he was actually singing this song. The song was very corny to me. That was like really, really corny. It didn't really make me laugh and it really wasn't real psychotic like, you know. But there was a play of the Killing Joke, and the individual had did it up on YouTube. It was a couple of years ago. I can put the link in the description, and I can mark the spot of the song. And that was more psychotic of the song of Jim Joker singing it, and it's directly from the graphic novel. And the way that they played it out was great. You know, I can actually put it up in the description box below, and y'all can check it out. But, you know, however, like I say, I give the movie a 6.5. And the only reason why I give it that, it has nothing to do with the actual story and the acting. Mainly the animation is what really hurt it for me, because the animation had to be very serious. And then certain other parts where they need to carry out some of the real hardcore sequences, that acting was not there. Okay, it was just that you could not feel it. It was like no type of emotion, like no anger, like no real, you know, like that in those sequences. If y'all go ahead and y'all watch it, y'all will understand what I mean. However, with me being a DC fanatic and me being a Batman hardcore fan, you know, it saddens me that I had to give it a 6.5 because of that. But it is over 50. It is close to a 7. And, you know, it's enjoyable. But then there's certain things that could particularly bother you and don't add up. And the way they portrayed Barbara Gordon and with Batgirl and stuff like that, you can look at it a different way. It was, like I say, it was entertaining. But there are certain things that will actually stick out and that can actually, that hindered it and it bothers you in certain aspects. Well, I hope y'all enjoyed my review. The description, in the description box, y'all can subscribe to my channel. Y'all can watch my other reviews. And y'all can also look at that sequence that I was talking about the Killing Joke from. It was, I can't remember the individuals, but I'll have it in the description box below. I will find it for you, and I'll put it in there, and then y'all can actually watch it. And then go from there. And I hope y'all enjoyed my review. Subscribe to the channel, put your comments down, and like the video. If you didn't like the video, still put your comments down and subscribe to the channel. Alright, this your boy Prime. Thanks for dropping in for Prime's reviews. And I hope to hear from you and see from you soon. Alright y'all, I'm out of here. Peace.